Get ready to match the stars. David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, on Harper Valley PTA, Edie McClure, Paul Williams, and Joyce Billabong as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Hello, friend. How do you do?
Hello.
Hello.
We have a new kid on the block, and we've got to give her a proper greeting. I forgot my breath spritz. Oh, thank you very much.
Thank not going God. To help.
Well, we get a new a person here. She has to be properly welcomed.
Oh. Well, I'm so
It'll
thrilled.
Only take a minute, Edie.
Are you nervous?
Yes, I am.
Didn't know I could take your temperature with that, did you?
Ready?
Yes.
Welcome, Edie. Not on the cheek. Don't turn your cheek to me. Don't turn the other cheek. Give me your lips, woman. Lips is what I want. Mwah. Oh. The last time you saw Edie probably was on the David Letterman show. Is that right?
Yes.
The last time you saw you was on the David Letterman show. And where are we going to see you anyplace else soon?
Harper Valley PTA.
You're on via?
Yes, and yes. I'm also on WKRP in Cincinnati.
Yes.
Yes.
You're a busy lady.
Yes.
Well, welcome.
Thank you.
Now, depending on when you're receiving this show, in the previous tapings, Charles was not here.
I was away, yes.
He was away, and we...
He was away.
Well, they put him away for a while, is what they did.
I'm back now. I didn't want to... Then think it was like Susan Summers or someone just leaving in a huff.
Right, yeah.
No, I didn't want to, you know, get publicity or anything.
He had another job.
But I'm back.
We were in New York together.
You were.
We are not Diana Ross or anything.
Close personal friends of Burt Reynolds, and Burt wouldn't think of having a roast without having the two of us there to kind of make him feel better.
Right. And we're just getting older.
That's right.
If I told you 1,000 times, no eating on the show, Charles.
Maybe Susan Summers has the right idea.
All right, let's welcome Robin Spina and Doug Campbell. We want to get acquainted with you. Doug, we'll begin with you, please.
Did it go well? I just
from
back to
live in Orange County now, originally from Dayton, Ohio.
Yeah.
And I... I'm a telephone operator. I thought you might find a little interesting.
All right. Not I think that's quite it. Yeah.
Get quite a few comments about it, right?
Meet a lot of people that way, Doug?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. They have people, I'll answer the phone, and there'll be a long silence, and they'll say, is this the telephone company?
I heard a new one on the phone the other day, which surprised me. I picked up the phone to dial a number, and I couldn't find it, and I was fiddling around. All of a sudden, a recording came on and said, your time to dial has expired.
Right, yeah.
And that was the end of that. Yeah, Big Brother is watching someplace. All right, Doug, welcome, good luck. Robin, tell us about you, please.
Hi, I'm a secretary for a brokerage firm, recently living in North Hollywood and born and raised here in California.
All right, good luck to both of you. We'll begin with Doug, A or B, sir?
A.
Now, Kathy said my husband's table manners are so bad... Ah, shut up. He's the only man in the world who eats blank with his hands.
My husband's table manners are so bad, he's the only man in the world who eats blank with his hands.
Correct.
Gotcha. Got anything to tell me?
Not yet,
have you? Okay, Doug. Kathy said my husband's table manners are so bad, he's the only man in the world who eats blank with his hands.
Soup.
Soup. All right, Doug. That's you and David Doyle have. Then Harvey Korman.
I thought of soup, but then I thought I do eat it with my hands, so I went with mashed potatoes.
You don't. You rascal. Yes.
Remember when your kids were little and they used to do all that with the mashed potatoes
right.
And the thing all over from here? No, I didn't do that. It was too ugly to remember. I wanted something imaginative, something thrilling, something tempestuous, something exciting. Like a hot fudge nut sundae.
Uh-huh. That'd make a big mess, wouldn't it?
Sure. You'd have a good time. I wish I had one right now.
Okay.
She's getting older.
Pensive.
Well, I come in late. I'm not dressed as good as some of the others. I forget everybody's name, and I'm eating on the air, but damn it, I get the right answer.
Uh-huh. All right, Edie, this is your first time at bat. Let's see what you do.
Well, I guess I went to the other side of the world and I said spaghetti.
Spaghetti. That would be difficult and messy.
Some people try to be funny on this show. Some people try to even advance their own careers. I try to get the right answer.
Okay, Joyce.
I was with David. I had mashed potatoes.
All right. So, Doug picks up two in his first round question. Now let's see what we have for Robin. Art said, today I got good news and bad news. The good news is I met a girl with the body of a panther. The bad news is she has the face of a blank. Here we go. Art said, today I got good news and bad news. The good news is I met a girl with the body of a panther. The bad news is she has the face of a blank.
Gorilla.
A gorilla. Face of a gorilla, eh? All right. David?
I believe this is of the family, a baboon.
A baboon.
I think it's a gorilla.
Yeah, come on.
All right. I guess they're all of the large ape family, aren't they?
I think so.
Okay, Brett.
Some people show up late on this show. Some people show up badly dressed. Some people show up to advance their careers. Other people show up to get the answers wrong. Dog.
God.
Speaking of, oh, go ahead.
I come in late. I'm not wearing clothes like the rest of the people. I get everybody's name wrong and I'm eating on the air. But damn it, once again, I don't have to use the cop-out phrase. It's in the family. It's right on the nose. No, it's not. Baboon.
Oh, yeah.
Close enough.
Well, I come from a long line of knuckle-scraping mouth breathers, so I said ape.
Ape.
There it is. Three for her.
All right, Paul.
She was so ugly that she would give Faye Rain nightmares. Gorilla.
Gorilla.
Four. I didn't think that was going to work for you, but it's working great.
Okay, Joyce.
I didn't know how to spell it, but I knew how it looked. A laughing hyena.
Aha. 4-2 the score at the end of round one. Good game going here. More after this. Here we go. Round two coming up. And Robin, since you're ahead, you have to go first.
A.
A it is? Who plays? Brett.
Null and void up here.
And Joyce.
Well, I've never understood this. Are we being punished for being good?
No. You matched her in the previous round.
I see.
Now we come to round two, and since you've already matched her.
Very clear. I understand.
All right. I see the dummy on your lift. She didn't answer.
I see.
Uh-huh. Now, she has to play again. Susie said, I really had to make a sacrifice to buy my new car.
Oh, boy.
Unfortunately, I had to sacrifice my blank. All right. Ready, Brett?
I'm ready, sweetheart. I'm ready.
Susie said, I really had to make a sacrifice to buy my new car. Unfortunately, I had to sacrifice my blank.
My body.
Your body? Really?
How'd you like to ride in a Ferrari?
On you.
Sweet, innocent, naive secretary, virginal girl like her saying body? Mm.
It appalls me. It shocks me.
I would have expected it of you.
No. It's just, it's a despicable human being. I said fabulous, interesting, enchanting bod.
Uh-huh. All right. Time for Robin. Show us your body.
Okay.
And I'll show you mine.
For some people, it wouldn't be much of a sacrifice.
All right. Six for her. That means Doug has a little catching up to do. You need 4 to tie. That's the best you can do, Doug. Let's see if it happens. Jack said, you know you're getting old when a fortune teller offers to read your blank. You know you're getting old.
I'm going to get this one right, boy.
All right.
I don't write anyway. What am I worried about? I'm worried about it.
No, you matched in the previous round, Charles. You will learn how to play this game one of these days, Charles.
That'll make me living.
Jack said, you know you're getting old when a fortune teller offers to read your...
Wrinkles.
Wrinkles. Very good, Doug. Good answer from Doug. Wrinkles.
I almost went that route. I had face, but I changed it to even a more... fairy portent. Read your past.
Read your past. All right, so that means Robin wins it. What the rest of you have? Wrinkles. Wrinkles.
All right, Robert.
Thank you, Harold.
Thank you.
Didn't jug off here, but you won't be gone very long because you'll be back later for game number two. All right? Now, would you stand there if you please? And we'll have a go at it here. We could win over $10,000 here, Robin. Good luck to you. Here's the way it goes. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank lately.
Oh, couple of weeks.
Blank lately. All right, you may call on three of the stars.
Paul.
Johnny Come Lately.
Oh. Johnny Come Lately is his.
Brett.
What?
You.
Me? Oh, had any lately?
Oh,
all right.
Yeah.
Oh. Beer rats, a root beer.
Oh, Joyce? Oh, shoot. Lately. Oh. Haven't seen you lately.
Haven't seen you lately. All right. Johnny Come Lately and the other one. You want one of those or one of your own?
The one that Joyce said.
Oh, no.
No!
Oh, no. I don't think that's a good idea.
You really want that one?
Yeah.
All right, she says, haven't seen you lately is the one she wants. All right, the audience reacted so positively to Johnny Come Lately, I thought you might have chosen that, but sometimes they can be misleading, can't you? No.
Oh. I don't think so this time, all right. Darling.
All right, let's take a look at the $100 response. Where have you been lately?
That's sort of like I haven't seen.
That's, they were long close before. To haven't seen you lately, but I don't think you're going to see haven't seen you lately up there, my dear. Let's take a look at the next one. Not lately. All right, last chance for haven't seen you lately. That's reveal it anyway. Johnny Come Lately. That's Paul's answer. Now, Robin, we'll get Doug back here and play game number two. So welcome back to Doug Campbell here. Well, you weren't gone very long.
No.
We'll give you a chance to get settled in here, and we'll do a little business with America in the meantime. Oh, wait a minute. Come over here.
Yes.
Did you have a question, Edie?
No, I didn't have a question.
You didn't have a question?
No. Wait,
I want you to be perfectly comfortable here. This is your first time.
Yes, it is.
Would you tell Dick Contino we found the other hat?
Is that an El Cheapo, or does it sound like anything?
It says find it. No, it says something like that. This is always underneath there when I'm...
Oh, that's in terrible tune. You can't do anything with that.
Oh, yes, but they're all obscene. whenever I'm on the show, it's always down here.
It is.
Well, taste for, to make me feel at home.
If we got you a good one, you might be impelled to give us a little tune there.
That's dangerous, being impelled, isn't it?
Yes.
Impelled on your own petard.
Are you ready? Here we go. Doug, A or B?
Try A again.
All right. Unlucky Louie said, let me tell you about my rotten luck. Yesterday, the government called to tell me that they were building a blank in my backyard. Good.
Good answer. Play.
That's wrong show, isn't it? Sorry.
What came over the little dog?
Play!
She thought she was on another show. all right. Chuck?
Coming.
See? Some things never change.
That man on that other show is a nice man. That other show. That other nice man.
Sure.
Oh, you could be nice once in a while. You just don't commit.
That's right. Unlucky Louie said, let me tell you about my rotten luck. Yesterday, the government called to tell me that they were building a blank in my backyard.
The only thing I could think of was airbase.
You know, airbase.
Yeah, you know, where the airplanes and rockets and things like that go.
I don't think it's going to get you too far. It won't fly. It'll never fly, Doug.
Never fly.
What do you say?
I went with a disposal dump.
Really?
Uh-huh. I went with that.
All right.
See me leaving?
Yes.
I'm taking my glasses off for this, but I'm leaning back. So you don't want to get too close. Don't get too tight on me, hon. I think this is going to be the popular fave. Nuclear plant.
Yeah. Very good.
There.
Splendid.
Nuclear plant.
All right.
From the movie of the same name.
All right, that's two of those, Edie.
All right.
I don't want to go back to Three Mile Island.
Join a club.
I might remind you that evidently somebody has to keep you abreast of these things. Nuclear reactors are owned by private corporations such as Con Ed. I said a prison which is built by a government.
Right.
He's just copping out for a rotten answer.
No, prison is not a bad answer to have in your backyard. What do you say, Joyce?
I feel that was an excellent answer. And the man's name being Louie, you know, I said a pen.
A pen. All right.
That's right.
Now, here we go with the other round one question, Robin. Tex said, last night, I went to the world's strangest country and western bar.
Who said that, Tex?
Your heart's not in it. Strange country and western bar. Instead of a mechanical bucking bull, it had a mechanical bucking blank.
Instead of a mechanical bucking... What the hell is a...
And there's a fashionable thing in bars now to have a mechanical bucking bull. And when you get half a load on, which is something that you know about, you get on this bucking bull, you put a quarter in the thing, and then it tries to throw you into the sawdust.
You! How about that?
Here we go. Tex said, last night I went to the world's strangest country and western bar. Instead of a mechanical bucking bull, it had a mechanical bucking blank.
Donkey.
Donkey. Yes. Donkey. That'll,
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, this is wonderful. Who was paying attention?
Oh.
The fabulous Mr. David Doyle,
this
who was paying
pathetic.
Close attention, will now show you his answer.
I gave her all this information. I said, you must be very careful because it's blank in something. But it's not blank in something.
It's a mechanical bucking blank.
Oh, of course. Well, I'm completely wrong.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Absolutely, because I...
You have to show it anyway.
Yes, well, it's just I put down milking machine because I thought it was blanking blank. Oh.
It had a mechanical blanking blank.
I know.
Yeah.
All wrong. Very good over here.
Well, he's just so upset. You know, he goes crazy when he doesn't get the right answer. It just makes him so upset. I said, I think that my answer is fabulous. I mean, I really like it. Fucking broad.
All right. Okay. Yeah, I think that's quite good.
I have my supper on a tray in my room.
We've already arranged
away from the other patients.
Yes.
Now, this requires a little thinking.
Ha!
Saw.
Does that stink or does
it
that stink?
It had a mechanical
stink?
Bucking saw.
A buck saw.
Buck saw.
A buck saw.
Wait a minute.
A buck saw, so it's now a bucking saw.
A buck saw.
Take your bucking saw and get out of here.
Yes. All right, Edie.
Well, I don't know about you, but Whirly Jean Pickens, whenever she goes to one of them bars, she's looking for a mechanical bucking cowboy.
Uh-huh.
A buck board, I can see the connection, but a buck saw, I have a little trouble with.
Oh, yes. Write a song.
Is it playing?
Write a song.
I wrote a title song for the show, but you know, everybody laughed at it, so we threw it away. There's a little place on Santa Monica we like to slip into when no one's looking to ride the bucking poodle.
Uh-huh. Really?
Well, maybe.
How is it?
I have one rule that I live by. I will try anything as long as it does not involve needles, large animals, or sleeping with a man. I am beginning to get soft on two of those, and I'm not going to tell you what they are.
Now, is that a song or what?
I don't know.
It will
be. Beginning of one.
It's germinating. It's happening in his head.
Two out of three.
Yeah. All right, what have you got there, Joyce?
I agree, there's nothing better than a bucking cowboy.
Instead of a mechanical bucking bull, I had a mechanical bucking cowboy.
What?
All right, there's round one. They were really kind of hard questions. That's why neither of you scored. But you will later. Right now, this for you. That's true. We were just saying what a wonderful, amusing, gifted lady Edie is. It's a pleasure to have you here. This is her first time she's done the show.
Thank you.
And we'd like to have you. Look forward to seeing you every time. Anything else I can do for anybody?
It's nice to be back. I'm sorry I had to miss a few weeks. 2 weeks.
Thank you, Charles.
Say goodnight.
Good night. Gene Rayburn here. See you tomorrow. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive a cheese server and Gino's Party Special Pizza with a crisp, tasty crust you can trust, plus the flavor shaker. Gino's in your grocer's freezer. And paper-made freezer wrap, the ideal way for protecting the food you freeze for future use, goes right from freezer to microwave. Paper-made freezer wrap from James River Corporation. A tray and strong hair is Wella Balls and beautiful hair. Look for the original Wella Balls and instant conditioner, the beautiful new bottle, Wella, name you can trust. A calculator and step saver, ideal for no-wax floors, too, because it cleans without dulling, shines without buildup. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Taubman production. Program was edited for broadcast.